Water is very much overexploited in this region. One of the things that has happened in the Middle Atlas is that the number of surface springs has declined from around 26 to 4 that are flowing all year round, which indicates a decline of the water table. Farmers who could rely on a well that's 40 meters deep now have to dig 100 meters, 150 meters, 160 meters deep to get to water. So as a result, there is a kind of risk to the loss of the aquifer, which is very significant and very real.
L'irrigation en général, on a fait à partir d'un certain nombre de ressources. Actuellement, on a atteint 1,5 million d'hectares irrigués. On connaît déjà que 80% de nos ressources nationales sont destinées à cette activité. Donc, il y a un intérêt économique et social en matière d'irrigation. D'irrigation qui sont très anciens, à savoir tout ce qui est gravitaire, donc c'est un système qui est consommateur d'eau. Il y a aussi les systèmes d'aspersion qui nécessitent de l'énergie, c'est-à-dire on ne peut pas dire traditionnel, mais en même temps ça consomme assez d'eau. Et on a d'un autre côté l'irrigation localisée qui consiste par exemple à l'utilisation d'irrigation par goutte à goutte ou micro-aspersion pour les arbres ou pour les bananiers.
Drip irrigation is relatively new. Here in the Seis, Meknesfes and the region, it's more and more popular, but it still needs some awareness efforts. It gives you just the quantity of water that the plant needs in the right timing. So with drip irrigation, you pump just the necessary amount of water, so it's very efficient. Now, how much you pay to pump, how much it costs you, it depends on whether you use diesel or gas or other energies.
The big impact of drip irrigation is not necessarily on reducing water use. I want to emphasize that. The big impact, as far as the farmers are concerned, is that drip irrigation dramatically reduces labor costs. In terms of the water use, we don't know yet what the full impact will be, because we're risking what is called Jevons paradox. When a resource becomes more efficiently used, sometimes it's overused. We have to combine drip irrigation with a lot of information for farmers. Your tree needs this much water. Your crop needs this much water. There are lots of wells that are dug by people who don't know that you need a permit, for example. So as a result, there are more wells than are officially acknowledged and licensed. Wells have become cheaper today as machines arrived that formerly worked in places like Syria. And that has made for a proliferation of wells, whereas in the past it was more expensive and took a lot more energy to dig one. So the aquifer is declining. So unless there is a measure made to kind of reverse the decline of the Seis aquifer, we could end up losing it. Many farmers cannot afford efficient systems for water use. In the Plan Maroc Vert, there is a solidarity aspect of the plan that included loans for smaller farmers and assistance to smaller farmers. And drip irrigation systems are partially covered by that. The main problem there is many farmers simply don't know that this plan also covers them.
Seen in the COP22, we try as much as possible to reduce the use of conventional energies. So the idea now is to use solar energy as as the energy for the engine that pumps.